It was important for us to understand the cultural processes and phenomena that are a huge factor in the creation of the personal identities of our participants in second chance education projects. Duisburg is home to 85,000 people of Turkish origin. Other estimates suggest that the Turkish population is as many as 100,000. The new Merkez Mosque, the largest Muslim place of worship in a non-Muslim country, was built with the help, by the way, of contribution of 3.2 million euros from the EU and the state of North Rhine-Westphalia. Marxloh itself has around 180,000 inhabitants, with 6,000 of them being foreigners. 4,000 of these are Turkish, and that's not counting those who have Turkish roots but are German citizens.
Those typical Turkish tea glasses, the little ones that they've got? That was where the paint was in there, little, you know, a little brush and just like this. You know, all this is just done by hand. No, no, most of it's tiles, isn't it? It's painted. So it's all painted, yeah. The little tiny little brush.
The Merkez Mosque holds 800 worshippers plus 400 worshippers on the upper level. It was finished in 2008 with the aid of the funds from the EU, the state of North Rhine-Westphalia and donations from worshippers. The 3.2 million in EU funds have been used exclusively for the creation of the intercultural center in the basement of the mosque, where people can meet and find information on the Muslim faith.
Hier war das so, dass als damals die Heim waren, ne? Und die ersten ihre Familien rübergeholt haben, sind die hier hingezogen. Weil sie sich gedacht haben, so alles klar ist ja gegenüber, dann ziehen wir da hin. Und das wurde dann zum Türkenviertel quasi. Ne? Hier, diese Geschichte. Und so ist dann halt dieses Wort Parallelgesellschaft ist dann auch entstanden. Weil komplett der ganze Innenhof nur türkisch war.
A large part of Marxloh was built during the industrialization of the Ruhr area between 1880 and 1910. Steel industry is still very much present in the cityscape, although this part of Duisburg has been undergoing a major structural change since the 1980s. Thousands of people were laid off when the steel industry faced major crises. Faced with the choice of writing hundreds of applications and still not being offered a job, many Turks decided to set up shops in Marxloh and create their own jobs. A direct result of this is the bridal wear center of Europe, where along the Weseler Straße you can find scores of fashion shops specially geared towards meeting the tastes and needs of brides and grooms to be with Turkish roots. What you see here has all been designed in Marxloh with Turkish taste in mind. There is fierce competition between the individual designer labels, and even niche markets within the niche have been established, for example bridal wear for tall people. This is the reason why thousands of brides and grooms-to-be all buy their outfits in Marxloh.
Ja, wer kann denn was dazu erzählen? Du kannst doch bestimmt was dazu erzählen.
Ja, mittlerweile du auch.
Okay, was soll ich dir verkaufen? Sagst du.
The visit has been a real eye-opener and illustrated the synergy of pride in one's roots and business development perfectly.